Hey everybody, Omar here, the Knife Shark Guy, and I am back with another discussion video. Maybe you'll find this one interesting, maybe you won't. But today's topic, using your knife. Yeah, that's the topic today. Using your knife, because I keep hearing that all the time. I show off these really awesome customs and people say, well, do you use them? You know, I don't know. I mean, I feel like I want to tell them, look, give me a break, man. I like knives because I like the way they look. And I started thinking, why am I into this hobby? And to be honest with you, I think I'm more into the aspect of knife collecting as an art piece more than as a tool. Now, the four knives you see in front of you, I have used them. I've used them lightly, but yes, all four knives on here have been used. And these are actually my favorite customs too. It's not like, I choose which one to use. I use all of my knives, but it got me thinking, when you have people out there that do something so creative with knives, I mean, if you look at this piece, is this a knife that you're going to go running out into the woods? You're going to take camping with you and use it as a survival knife? I don't think so. Not for the price. Not only are knives like this, more artistic, but I mean, they're mechanically artistic as well. Customs are just a completely different world because every knife maker has to try to fulfill the need for the knife being a tool. Hello, a tool. And yet still retain some sort of artistic quality too, because every knife maker is completely different and they do completely different things with knives. In a lot of cases, you're in customs, you're probably really buying the maker rather than the tool, which is, at least in my opinion, that seems to be true. So in front of you, you see a knife made by Des Horn, a knife made by Andre Thorburn, a knife made by Arukus Blumeris, and a knife made by John Arnold. I mean, the four knives here, we've got, I'm going to call this somewhat a full dress piece. You got like two full dress pieces and like regular custom knives, but even just a regular custom knife seems a little bit too nice to be used. I mean, because really, even if guys that are not into customs, right? Let's say you're into not budget folders, but maybe somewhat of a high-end knife, or even midline knives. Some of us will actually, because we're knife collectors, we have the habit of maybe buying two of them, beating the crap out of one, and then keeping another one and safe queening it. It's just what we do. It's just what we are. All knife people have experienced that, safe queening or buying two and all that. So, and it's because we love that, we love just the way a knife looks. We want to be able to keep it new. We want to just enjoy carrying it in our pocket. And that brings up another question, right? Suppose I never cut with any of these knives, right? Suppose I never cut with any one of them, but I carry each of these knives every day, all day long, and I never, ever use them. But the question is, when you say use it, do you use the knife? I mean, how many people out there, even people that work in an industry, in a tool industry, do they use their knife every day? That hard use where you're getting value out of it? I mean, it kind of makes you wonder, what is value to you when it comes to knives? I mean, is using, is basically carrying a knife every day, right? Flipping it, closing it, enjoying the action of the knife, but you never really cut with it, right? You never do that one thing with the knife. You just kind of flip it. You carry it every day. You put it in your pocket. You look at it. Maybe you flip it while you're watching TV. Excuse me. What's that worth to you? Is it worth, the price that you paid for the knife? I think that should be something up to every individual that's into this hobby. We should never, ever question someone else's motives for being in this hobby. We're all in this together. We're all a bunch of knife nuts. We all enjoy knives the way we want to enjoy them. It's no crime. And if somebody wants to go out there and buy a $1,200 knife only to just kind of sit there and do this all day, look at it, flip it, admire it, carry it every day, go home and start the cycle all over again. Not safe cleaning it. He's actually having it on him every day, enjoying it in some capacity. The only thing he's not doing is he's not cutting with it every day. Now, I think we place too much emphasis on do you use the knife. This is a hobby, all right? And when you get to the world of customs, you're talking about knife makers that make things specifically. I mean, I don't really need an eagle on my tool, do I? You know, I don't really need fancy file work on my tool. If I wanted to just get a knife to use and beat the crap out of, you know, hats off to us. You know, let's just get one of these and do that. But that's not why I'm into this hobby. There are users out there that use their knives aggressively, and they still collect. But they collect the way they want to collect. I collect the way I want to collect. Yeah, I like to spend ridiculous amounts of money on knives, if only just to carry, just to look at, just to admire. And if I'm lucky, I'll get a chance to use the knife. You know, it's just something that I was thinking about. And it's kind of like there's no law that says you have to buy a knife and use the knife the way that other people think you should be using it. Or maybe they think you're nuts or whatever. This is the hobby we've chosen. You know, it's... And I always look at it this way. I think I'm lucky enough to have chosen a hobby that require, you know, that can be seen as... art, not just art, but sometimes mechanical art. I mean, even like the, you know, even like just the insides, you know, of the knife can be art. Case in point, as with Des Horn. Now, this knife, unlike the other three knives on this table, these knives here, they all run on ball bearings. Now, Des Horn, he doesn't believe in ball bearings all the time. He believes that a knife can be awesome just on washers, and the way he does it, I mean, this is just as smooth as any ball bearing knife I've ever had, and it only runs on washers. I mean, this knife is as solid as a rock. It's got a nice razor sharp blade. I mean, the blade itself is a piece of art to me. This blade is Nitrobe 77. It goes through a very special heat treatment, then it's dipped in liquid nitrogen, and the person that's responsible for doing it is Des Horn. So you are kind of buying the knife maker in a way when you're getting your custom knives. Again, this is a functioning tool. Am I going to be using this and abusing it and going out camping with it and, you know, having it, you know, just lying around in my toolbox? Hell no. You know, this knife is an art piece, and it should be treated as such. At least that's the way I see it. Like I say, I look at knives when I got to this level. I started looking at knives more for the art aspect than as the tool aspect. Yes, I will be pissed off if one of the knives on this table can't cut a piece of paper, but nevertheless, I mean, these things are beautiful works of art and should be looked at that to a degree. If it happens to be in my pocket and somebody needs to cut something with it, yeah, I'll be the one cutting it, not them, but I'll use my own knife to cut with it. Yeah. But, you know, I didn't buy these knives to look at these knives as regular tools. I didn't buy them just to use them and then, you know, they're not just tools to me. They're works of art. And I think that that's the question of today's video is using the knife really all that important to you as an individual knife collector? How important is that to you as a knife collector? Some of you guys are like me. You're into knives for the elegance of it. Others are more into the overall experience of a knife, the action, What kind of blade finish it has, whatever it is that turns you on about knives. Well, this is what turns me on about knives. And I just wish that we could all kind of like respect each other's love for the hobby, because it's that love of the hobby that keeps all of us tied up and tied in together. And we all share that same commonality. We just decide to share that commonality the way we want it to share it. And if it turns out I don't get a chance to cut with the knife every day, and you don't get a chance to cut with your knife every day, I think that's okay. As long as you're getting the enjoyment out of the knife. Don't get me wrong, if you buy an $800 custom knife and it just sits in a drawer, being safe queened, you might as well get rid of it and sell it to somebody that's really going to appreciate it in some way, on some level, so it at least can be appreciated. Because I can guarantee you that Des Horn, Andre Thorburn, Arugus Blumeris, and even John Arnold, all these guys would be happy knowing that I'm using their knife in some way, in some capacity. They would probably be perfectly happy knowing that I'm carrying their knife every day, or at least every other day. And they're the guys that made the knives. But I'm pretty sure none of them would be happy if one of their knives was sitting in a drawer or just not being used, or just being safe clean forever. I don't think any knife maker wants that. So, just wanted to point out that the four knives that you see in front of you, these are my all-time favorites in my entire collection. I do love the other 20 customs that I have, but as far as standing out, these are the ones that I tend to carry the most in my pocket. So once again, that would be Des Horn, Andre Thorburn, Arugus Blumeris, and John Arnold. These are all South African knife makers. I call these guys the Beatles of knife making. We got John, Paul, George, and Ringo. So for you millennials out there who don't know who John, Paul, George, and Ringo is, go ask your parents. This is Omar, the Knife Shark Guy, signing off on my quick discussion on using the knife and how you appreciate your knives. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this discussion was kind of interesting for you, or if anyone was feeling a little bit reserved about their hobby, or you know how you get. It's like, you collect knives? What's the matter with you? What are you, nuts? Don't be nuts. This is a fun hobby. We enjoy it. It just so happens that our hobby happens to be pointy things, right? Thank you so much for watching. This is Omar, the Knife Shark Guy, signing off. I have enjoyed doing this video. We're going to have more videos along the way. Thank you so much for watching, and you guys have a good evening.